This is just a knowledge sharing session. And hello all, my name is Nilesh and I'm working as a senior software engineer in one of the IT company in Pune. So before starting the session, I would like to have some basic instruction to all the participants. So please mute yourself, and whenever I ask you anything, then only unmute yourself and you can answer it. You can write down your queries and question in the chat box. And during the session, if in case like net, if there any network issue or power failure happens, you will be intimated through the WhatsApp group. Okay, so please be connected. That's all about the instruction. There is general note before the starting the presentation, like all the logos and images which are used in the presentation are owned by the respective companies only. Just using here is just for the reference purpose. Okay, so let's get started. So what do you know about the Jenkins? I would like to answer from everybody. It might be chances like before few years ago, I was completely new in the
years
Jenkins.
Ago, I was completely new in the Jenkins.
Yeah. Let me know. Yes, you can unmute yourself and answer what you know about the Jenkins.
Hi, Vijay here. Can you hear me, guys?
Yes. Yes, Vijay.
Yeah, so Jenkins, we can say short as a it's a continuous integration, continuous development tool where if we made some changes in the code and if we are we don't need to push it manually, it will happen automatically. You can say this, that's why you can call it as a continuous integration, continuous development.
Okay, thanks Vijay. Many of the participant has posted in the chat box like it is a CI tool. It is for few participants, it is a new. Okay, how many participants are hearing first time like about the Jenkins and all? Okay, I see a couple of hands. So okay, so most of the answers are like yeah, okay, good. Most of the participants have like basic idea about the Jenkins, and few participants are new to the Jenkins. Okay, so I will consider, so this is very basic session of the Jenkins. Okay, so I'll cover up the concepts from the basic itself, how the in industry, how the processes are like done. And I think many of the participants are working in the IT industry. They also have using the Jenkins in their company, then in their projects, they do have their different processes. Okay, but I'm just sharing my experience in like how we use it the Jenkins in my project. Okay, so yeah, so thank you guys. Okay, thank you guys for the confirmation. So basically participants, like I can say people are saying like Jenkins is a CI tool. Okay, so I'll start from the basics of the CI, but before that I would like to go through the agenda for this session. Like the very first, we will see the how was before the hello. Yeah, so how was before the integration, CI integration, then what is continuous integration, we will see. Then we'll see one use case of the Nokia, and then we'll see some continuous integration tools which are available in the market. Then we'll see about what is CD, then we'll see some DevOps concept, and then we'll start learning about the Jenkins and how Jenkins is useful in automation testing, and Jenkins, then after that we'll see the Jenkins distributed architecture. And there are a couple of hands-on session followed by this theoretical slides. Okay, so I think in the hands-on session we'll going to see this kind of topics like Jenkins installation, we will see, then how to add the new users in the Jenkins, then how to install the plugins in the Jenkins, then very important like configuration of Maven, Jenkins, GitHub, how to do that in the Jenkins, that we'll see. And then we'll see the how to create the jobs in Jenkins, how to configure the email server, then how to install the Sonar Lint in the Eclipse. Then also we will see the Sonar Cube configuration in the Jenkins, and master slave configuration in the Jenkins, and then Jenkins pipeline. I would like to cover this Jenkins in this session only, but might be this. Let's see. Like I have planned this Jenkins pipeline in the next session. Okay, but very big agenda for this today's session. So please bear with me. Okay. Okay, so let's start with the before continuous integration. I would like to explain this. Let's consider one scenario, like there are three developers. Okay, so one is sitting at US side, one is sitting at the UK side, and another developer who is sitting at the India, right? So consider these three developers who are working on the Facebook project, okay? Who are working on the Facebook project. And suddenly the Facebook decided to add one functionality into their project. Okay, so I always take the example as a UPI functionality. Okay, so Facebook decided to add, give me 1 second, I'll just enable the annotation. Yeah, okay, so Facebook decided to add UPI functionality. Okay. Okay, into their project. Now what will happen, like USA, the developer, okay, so they did planning and all everything, and they decided to finish this functionality within a week. Okay, so in the planning they decided to finish.
I do interrupt, the voice is not clear. Yes sir.
Okay. Okay, thanks for the feedback. Is it okay now? Hello?
Yes, fine.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, thank you, Nikhil. Yeah. So Facebook decided to add a UPI functionality, and the team decided the UPI functionality will take 1 week to finish it. Okay. Now, consider on Monday this developer committed some code, okay, to the this central repository. Okay, now on Tuesday this developer committed the code, then Wednesday this developer committed the code. Okay, accordingly throughout the week these three developers are committing to the this central repository. Okay, now what happens, Friday came, and this team decided that our UPI functionality implementation is completed. Okay, so everything, the UPI functionality code is there in the code repository. Okay, in the code repository, central code repository. Now the another team come into the picture, like the team will integrate this code and try to build it. Okay, in this stage what this team will do, this team will try to integrate the code and try to build it. Now after 1 week this team has observed that the build is failing. Now the team is observed that the build is failing. Now the problem is they don't understand because of whose commit this build is failing. Samajh mein aa raha hai? इस टीम को यही पता नहीं चल रहा है कि किसके कमिट की वजह से
नहीं चल रहा है कि किसके कमिट की वजह से
I think there is an echo. I think participant, please mute yourself.
Participant.
Give me 1 minute. Okay, so Yeah, I think all participants are muted. Let's see. I don't know why it is echoing. Okay, so where I was? Yeah, at this stage. Okay, so now this team will build the code, and they found that the build is failing, right? Now, अभी उनको यही नहीं पता चल रहा है कि because of whose commit this build is failing, right? That's the big issue with the previous and before the continuous integration. Okay, now sometimes like now this feedback this team will give it to the this team. Okay, guys, this build is failing. I try to fix the issues. Okay, अभी ये लोग क्या करेंगे? This team will try to spend some time to fix this build issue. कि क्यों बिल्ड फेल हो गया है. फिर ये डेवलपर बोलेगा आई हैवंट डिड एनीथिंग रॉन्ग, माय कमिट्स आर फाइन. ओके, सो यू चेक योर बिल्ड, यू चेक योर कमिट्स. ओके, ये बोलेगा कि मैंने भी कमिट किया था, एवरीथिंग वर्क्स फाइन. ये इसको बोलेगा. ओके, सो दिस वाज द इशू. एवरीबॉडी इज ब्लेमिंग ऑन ईच अदर. ओके, नाउ सडनली द मैनेजर विल डिसाइड, टीम हैज टू कम टुगेदर एंड डिसाइड और रिजॉल्व दिस इशू. ओके, तो फिर इन्होंने एक साथ में आके फिर इन्होंने अपना बिल्ड रिजॉल्व किया. बिल्ड के जो इश्यूज थे, दे ट्राई टू रिजॉल्व द इश्यूज इन द बिल्ड. नाउ समहाउ दिस टीम हैज क्रिएटेड अ बिल्ड सक्सेसफुली. अभी जब बिल्ड सक्सेसफुल हो गया, नाउ दिस टू बी डिप्लॉयड ऑन द टेस्टिंग एनवायरमेंट. ओके, नाउ द टेस्टिंग टीम विल कम इन टू द पिक्चर. नाउ दिस टीम विल टेस्ट दिस बिल्ड एंड ट्राई टू गिव द फीडबैक ऑफ दिस बिल्ड, like any bugs or issues in the build. Okay, so this testing team will take some time and try to execute the test cases and will give the feedback to the development team. Abhi hua kya, ye jo before the continuous integration mein kya issues the, ki jab testing team ko build mila, okay, before that building time, okay, tab tak ye टेस्टिंग वाली जो टीम थी, इट वॉज आइडल, राइट? इट वॉज जस्ट राइटिंग द टेस्ट केसेस, बट दे डोंट हैव एनीथिंग इन हैंड टू एग्जीक्यूट द टेस्ट केस, राइट? जब इनको ये मिला, एंड टिल द टाइम दिस टीम विल बी आइडल. ओके, नाउ टू गेटिंग द फीडबैक फ्रॉम द टेस्टिंग टीम टू डेवलपर टीम, ओके, इट वॉज टेकिंग सो मच ऑफ टाइम. ओके, नाउ वंस द टेस्टिंग टीम रेज द कंसर्न, ओके, कि ये इश्यूज है, नाउ अगेन दे विल फिक्स इट एंड अगेन दे ट्राई टू इंटीग्रेट इन, अगेन दे क्रिएट अ न्यू बिल्ड एंड अगेन दिस टेस्टिंग टीम विल टेस्ट दिस बिल्ड. ओके, सम हाउ इट लुक्स हैप, दिस इज हाउ इट वर्क्स. ओके, एंड फाइनली आफ्टर द टेस्टिंग दिस सॉफ्टवेयर इज रिलीज, राइट? सो लेट्स सी द सम इश्यूज इन द or the problems in the existing or the I can say the before continuous integration. Okay, so entire source code build and then tested. Okay, yahan pe kya hua, in tino ne UPI functionality complete ki, after that they integrated the code. Okay, and after that they tested the code, right? So this was just a time, it is just taking so much of time, and because of that locating the bug and fixing that bug is very difficult and time consuming. Okay, the software developer has to wait for the test result and the complete process is a manual. So this was the problem in the continuous integration, before the continuous integration. Okay, so after that, to resolve these issues, the CI come into the picture. Okay, so let us understand what is CI is. Okay, just want to inform to the participants that before getting or before jump into the Jenkins, we would like to clear with the some concept like what is CI, what is CD, how it came into the picture, and then we will see the Jenkins, right? Okay, so any question till now, you can ask me. Okay, or you can raise hand if you don't have any question.
Yeah, Andesh, you here?
Yes.
Yeah. So you know, as you started with the session, you word central repository. So right. Is that meaning something like we are checking the in GitHub or
right.
GitHub or in right. Bash, things like that?
Yes, it is just a central repository, which is your Git or SVN, right? So I don't want, I'm just going to explain in the next slide. So that's why just, this is a common terminology it is mentioned
over
here.
I just wanted to confirm.
Yes. You are correct. Yes, Vijay, you are correct. Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So anybody have any questions? So you got the problems like before continuous integration, which are the problems? These four problems, right? So can I move forward? Just give confirmation. Yeah.
Yes, Nilesh, you can move forward.
Okay, yeah. Okay, thank you. So let's see how the continuous integration come into the picture, or like what is the continuous integration. Okay, so continuous integration is a development practice which encourage developers to check in the code changes to source control as frequently as possible, since the code is checked in and integrated more often in smaller pieces. It is easier to identify and resolve the issues at the earlier stage. Okay, so I think maine pichle wale slide pe explain kiya tha, right? So I have explained in the previous slide what was the problems. Okay, so continuous integration mein kya hota hai, developers have a practice to check in the codes frequently, right, in the source code management system. And once the code has been checked, it is easy to identify and resolve the issues at the earlier stage. इनका क्या कहना है कि कंटिन्यूअस इंटीग्रेशन में क्या होता है, as soon as the developer committed his code, will try to build the code and try to execute the test cases, and because of this it will easier and identify to resolve the issues at the earlier stage. Okay, Turpti, can you just mute yourself? Yeah. Okay. Okay, thank you. I think still okay. So there is another definition which I got it from the Wikipedia. Okay, so continuous integration is a software engineering practice in which the frequent and isolated changes are immediately tested and reported on when they are added to the larger code base. Okay, so किसी भी project में कोई भी developer frequently and isolated changes commit करता है, right? So right away we will try to build it and we'll try to test it. Okay, so basically this is what about the integration, continuous integration. Okay, so I'll try to explain it on the next slide. Let me clear the. Okay, so let's try to understand the CI from this diagram. Okay, chalo abhi. Yeah, so what is it has written? Every abhi chalo ye jo developers hai, teen developers maine bole hai, right? Okay, now developer 1 ne jaise hi commit kiya central repository pe, okay, so what it will happen, it will trigger my build and execute the test case. So as soon as jaise hi meri continuous integration ko pata chala, because of this commit, one of the test case is failing. Okay, one of the test case is failing. Now my CI will intimate to this developer that this X test is failing because of your commit, right? Just fix it right away. Okay, okay, so every commit triggered an automated build in a separate CI server to execute the integration test. The code quality is maintained, since any build which has failing test are not allowed to get checked in into the source code repository, source control repository. Okay, so you got this complete CI in the picture, right? Okay, any question for this on this diagram? Pehle kya hota tha aur abhi kya ho raha hai? I just explain in the two scenarios. Okay, so we'll see on the next slide. Okay, so let's see, let's understand one of the use case in the Nokia, what was happening. Okay, so Nokia ne kya kiya? They decided to use one nightly build concept. Okay, so for developing the software product, Nokia was using the process called nightly build. Okay, so in nightly build process, at every night, the automated system pulls the code and pulls the code from the shared repository and tries to build it. ठीक है, तो नोकिया क्या किया, नोकिया ने क्या किया, एक नाइटली बिल्ड प्रोसेस अडॉप्ट किया. व्हाट दे आर डूइंग थ्रू आउट द डे, ये डेवलपर्स ने जितना भी कोड कमिट किया है थ्रू आउट द डे. ओके, कंसीडर फॉर एग्जांपल मिडनाइट एट 12, दिस सर्वर ट्राई टू पुल द चेंजेस एंड ट्राई टू बिल्ड द कोड. ओके, लेकिन हुआ क्या, व्हाट वॉज द प्रॉब्लम विद दिस नाइटली बिल्ड प्रोसेस, कि थ्रू आउट द डे देर आर 100 डेवलपर्स हु आर कमिटिंग दिस टू दी गिट रिपोजिटरी. ओके, तो 100 लोग दिन में 100 बार कमिट कर रहे हैं फॉर दिस रिपोजिटरी एंड एट नाइट एट 12 o'clock. ओके, नाउ दिस बिल्ड सर्वर इज पुलिंग दिस कोड एंड ट्राई टू बिल्ड द कोड. ओके, बट वॉट हैपन्स, सम हाउ दिस बिल्ड गॉट्स फेल्ड. ओके, सम हाउ द बिल्ड गॉट्स फेल्ड. अगेन द इशू, दे हैव टू अगेन इंटीमेट दिस टू द डेवलपर्स टीम दैट द बिल्ड इज फेलिंग. ओके, with the reason. Okay, but again they are not able to find out because of whose commit this build is failing. Okay, now because of this issue they try to adopt a new process which is a continuous integration. Fir unhone kya kiya, they try to switch over to the continuous integration from nightly build. So developer jab kabhi bhi commit karta tha apne git repository mein, that time only the CI server will try to pull the code and try to create a build for this new code. Okay, and if the build is failing, now this feedback is to be conveyed to the developer. Okay, so accordingly this is what the use case for the Nokia. Okay, let's see. So there are few tools available in the market, CI tools. One of the tool is Jenkins, इसके बारे में हम लोग देखेंगे. अनदर टूल इज टीम सिटी, ट्रेविस सी आई, सर्कल सी आई, गिट लैब, बाम्बू एंड टीम सिटी. दीज आर दी सम सी आई टूल्स विच आर अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. दीज आर दी लोगोस फॉर दिस टूल्स. ओके, सो जेनकिंस इज वेरी पॉपुलर इन द मार्केट नाउ डेज. ओके, टिल नाउ एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन आस्क मी. Okay. Yes.
Vijay, can you send it back?
Yes.
So in short, here, whatever use case Nokia has followed for nightly build, it was not able to show the because of which commit that build got failed. That's why they have included the continuous integration.
Nowadays you will get the intimation like which commit is failing, right? But this was the process before few years ago, like something you can say 10 years before, right? So what was the basic issue when the developers commit to the repository? Okay, they just try to integrate all the code. Okay, something like it, this developers has committed 100 times. Okay, so 100 commits, they try to integrate the code and try to build that code and then just notify to the team like build is failing or not. Correct, Vijay, is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so we'll see the next concept, that is continuous delivery. Okay, so mostly in the interview also they ask like what is CI, what is CD. So sometimes there is a bit confusion in the word, like what is CD. Okay, some people say that it is a continuous delivery, some people it says that continuous deployment. But CD comes in two categories, like one is continuous delivery and one is continuous deployment. Both are different processes. Okay, so let's see first of all what is CD, continuous delivery, and then we'll see the continuous deployment. Okay, Now, continuous delivery goes one step further than the continuous integration to automate the software release process where the code is deployed to the environment and prepared for the production release. अभी ये देखो ये जो पिक्चर है इसमें क्या किया डेवलपर ने कोड कमिट किया एंड आर सी आई टूल विच इज Jenkins हैज क्रिएटेड अ बिल्ड ओके एंड ऑटोमेटिकली इट इज डिप्लॉयड ऑन द स्टेजिंग सर्वर और टेस्ट सर्वर यू कैन कंसिडर ओके नाउ टिल दिस प्रोसेस एवरीथिंग इज ऑटोमेटेड ठीक है टेस्टिंग एनवायरनमेंट तक आपका कोड डिप्लॉय हो गया टेस्टिंग टीम इज ऑल्सो टेस्टिंग ओके और यू कैन सी अ प्री प्रॉड एनवायरनमेंट तक आपका कोड डिप्लॉय हो गया अभी इसके आगे प्रोडक्शन में जाना है कि नहीं दैट इज डिसाइडेड बाय द मैनुअल प्रोसेस सो कंटिन्यूस डिलीवरी में क्या होता है योर कोड इज मेड रेडी टिल द रिलीज और यू कैन से योर कोड or simple in short you can say a continuous delivery is a to create a code version which is ready to deploy on the production okay aapka code production ke liye ready hai ki nahi hai ye yahan tak ki process hai that is called as a continuous delivery okay you can say right now let's understand what is the manual process okay abhi manual process kaise hoti hai yahan pe production mein jana hai ki nahi abhi मैंने पहले एक प्रोजेक्ट पे काम कर रहा था विच वॉज कैनेडा बेस्ड प्रोजेक्ट ओके सो वहाँ पे ये टीम कैसे डिसाइड करती थी कि प्रोडक्शन में लेके जाना है कि नहीं ओके सबसे पहले दे डू अ मीटिंग ओके सो विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ गो नो गो मीटिंग विच वॉज कॉल्ड एज अ ओके सो इन दिस मीटिंग हु ऑल आर देयर ऑल योर मैनेजर्स स्टेक होल्डर्स ओके और ऑल योर डिलीवरी मैनेजर्स योर डेवलपमेंट टीम लीड योर डेवलपमेंट टीम मैनेजर ओके ये सारे लोग इसका पार्ट रहते हैं तो ये गो नो गो मीटिंग में क्या होता है दे डिसाइडेड कि अपना जो अभी रिलीज है ओके इज इट अ प्रोडक्शन रेडी सबसे पहले वो डिस्कस करेंगे then risk factor they'll decide okay so many companies deploy to production only after getting approval from the business stakeholders jab is meeting mein kaha gaya ki go then only this they deployed this code into the production okay and before deploying the code to the production they have to do the UAT okay user acceptance test also they have to finish it okay only after getting the thumbs up in the user acceptance testing the code is deployed to the production environment okay so I think continuous delivery is much clear okay anybody has a doubt in the continuous delivery you can ask production is your the server okay yeah
Can I just share me about what types of risk factor which we associated it?
Risk factor like when you integrate the code or this code goes into the production. Okay, any impacts on the user or existing systems. Okay, they calculate this throughout the cycles. Okay, सबसे पहले मैं कुछ functionality add करता हूँ तो उसका risk factor भी उनको like consider I was in the project which related to the payment industry okay so payment industry mein kya hota hai koi bhi ek small change billions of dollar ka bhi loss kar sakta hai right so kabhi bhi wo production mein jate hai to they have to take the decision very carefully theek hai kyunki ek galat change gaya and because of that the system may get down or something the wrong transaction happens तो इसमें बिलियन डॉलर्स का भी लॉस हो सकता है राइट सो देयर आर मेनी रिस्क फैक्टर्स आई कैन से
सो सिंपली दे परफॉर्म द रिस्क बेस्ड टेस्टिंग
नॉट द रिस्क बेस्ड टेस्टिंग बिकॉज़ द टेस्टिंग कम्स इन द लाइक दिस रिलीज हैज टू गो फ्रॉम द वेरियस टेस्टिंग टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग लाइक फंक्शनल टेस्टिंग रिग्रेशन टेस्टिंग योर परफॉर्मेंस टेस्टिंग योर सिक्योरिटी टेस्टिंग एवरी स्टेज ही हैज टू क्लियर ओके द रिलीज हैज टू क्लियर then only it goes to the production okay now risk based testing I'm not aware about the risk based testing but they decide they just discuss the risk about the release right and they have to mitigate the risk before taking into the production okay
yeah yes, thanks
now let's understand what is CD okay now continuous deployment is the next step of the continuous delivery whereas every code every code commit that passes to the automated test and Sonar Cube quality gates in automatically deployed to the production, okay, without any manual intervention. Abhi hum logon ne dekha ki yahan tak everything was automated, but to my release goes to the production, this was the manual process, okay. मैनुअल प्रोसेस क्यों थी? बिकॉज द स्टेक होल्डर हैज टू टेक अ डिसीजन कि रिलीज मेरा प्रोडक्शन में जाना चाहिए कि नहीं जाना चाहिए. बट द सिस्टम और द प्रोजेक्ट हु इज कंटिन्यूस हु इज फॉलोइंग द कंटिन्यूस डिप्लॉयमेंट पाइपलाइन और साइकिल वेर एज दैट रिलीज गोज इन टू द प्रोडक्शन इन ऑटोमेटेड मैनर. ओके, सो टू डिलीवर हाई क्वालिटी बिजनेस फीचर टू द कस्टमर, वॉट इज द बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस इज कस्टमर को सारे फीचर्स वेरी फास्टली मिल जाते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कंटिन्यूस डिप्लॉयमेंट. यू कैन सी योर को योर चेंजेस इन द कोड एज क्विक एज पॉसिबल. ओके, सो एज पर माय नॉलेज मोस्ट ऑफ द कंपनीज अडॉप्टिंग सीआई एंड कंटिन्यूस डिलीवरी. ओके, बट वेरी फ्यू कंपनीज हु आर अडॉप्टिंग कंटिन्यूस डिप्लॉयमेंट ऑल्सो. ओके, now let's see what is matured CI pipeline with complete automation. Kab kaha jata hai ki you are following the 100% CD continuous deployment, when developer pushes the code to the source control, and if it passes the automated test, jaise hi developer ne commit kiya code and the code has passed all the automated test cases, and also the code has also passed the Sonar Cube quality gates, okay, and everything in this pre stage is validated and completed, and they feel that everything is good, now the code is going to be deployed to the production. So this is completely is called as automation process. Okay, CI/CD automation process. Okay, so main kab kahunga ki my all test cases are passed or what, something when my like something in Sonar Cube quality gates, there is something called as a concept which is called as a code coverage. Okay, so in my project there was coverage which was decided by the company is 90%. Okay, so the test case coverage should be a 90%. So this is what the complete automation is like, whenever the developer pushes the code into the source control management system, and then your automated test cases pass, and then Sonar quality gates also pass, and then this code is to be deployed to the production. So this is what we call it is as a complete automation. Okay, now let's see these three things into one picture. Okay, so what is CI? I said these two developers committing to the Git, and then build my CI server, you can say this is a build server, okay, which is taking the changes and creating a new build, and which is deployed on the test environment. Okay, so where you just execute the test cases and your integration test cases. So till now, till this, it is called as a continuous integration. Okay, now in continuous delivery, before the production, okay, so the code is ready for the production, it will make the code is ready for the production. Okay, so everything before the production, and the production will takes place as a manual process. Okay, and in the continuous deployment, everything jaise developer ne commit kiya, everything you are testing and code scanning and everything, okay, validating, ye sara process kaise hoga, deploying of the code into the multiple environments and going into the production, ye sari process hogi aapki automated. So this is what the complete process. Okay, so this is what the three concept in one picture. Okay, let's try to conclude the CI/CD. So continuous delivery makes your code release ready. Continuous delivery kya karega, aapka code release ready karega, but the decision to deploy the production is manual. Now business representative decide when the code to be pushed to the production. Okay, however, with the continuous deployment, the pipeline is completely automated all the way till the production without any manual action. So this was the conclusion from the previous slides. So any question till now for the CI/CD? Okay, go ahead. Production, what happens in the production, somebody is asking. Okay, so in production means consider you see the facebook.com is site. Okay, so right now it is in live. Okay, so in whenever any changes goes into the production, so that are visible by the users, I can say. Okay, And sometimes if any issue happens in the production or in the live, they have to fix it as soon as possible, because these are the hot fixes. Okay. Okay, so we'll next see the next slide. What is DevOps? Okay, so I'll try to just explain a very basic way. Like DevOps, it is not the tool. DevOps, it is a methodology which has a set of principles and practices that helps both developer and the operation teams to reach their goals. अभी क्या होता है, बड़े बड़े कंपनीज में क्या होता है, देर आर टू काइंड्स ऑफ द टीम्स, वन इज द डेवलपमेंट टीम एंड अनदर इज द ऑपरेशन टीम. तो अब डेवलपमेंट टीम का क्या है, कोडिंग करना, कोड लिखना, वट एवर इट इज, टेस्ट करना. ओके, डेवलपमेंट एंड टेस्टिंग टीम आई कैन से. ओके, सो दे डू इट एवरीथिंग एंड टू deployed into the production, the another team will take care of. Okay, so this is the operation team. Okay, तो अभी क्या होता था पहले जमाने में कि इन दोनों के बीच में बहुत सारे conflicts होते थे, right? So इसने consider this image, right? Now what he is saying that it works on my machine. Okay, before DevOps I'm saying. Okay, developer ने कुछ code लिखा, उसने उसके मशीन पे रन किया, एग्जीक्यूट किया, दैट्स फाइन. ओके, बट व्हेन ही प्रोवाइडेड दिस कोड टू द डेवऑप्स गाय और द ऑपरेशन टीम, ओके, तो उसने बोला कि ये कोड मेरे मशीन पे तो नहीं चल रहा है, राइट? सो आफ्टर डेवऑप्स इट वर्क्स ऑन, दिस इमेज इज सेइंग दैट इट वर्क्स ऑन माय कंटेनर. ओके, नाउ हियर द कांसेप्ट कॉल्ड एज कंटेनराइजेशन कम्स इनटू द पिक्चर. ओके, सो उसके बारे में अभी हम लोग नहीं देखेंगे, बिकॉज डॉकर एंड ऑल इट इज अ बिग कांसेप्ट. ओके, सो हम लोग उसके बारे में नेक्स्ट सेशन में देखेंगे, बट जस्ट ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन कि मुझे एक्सप्लेन क्या करना है यहाँ पे, कि ये जो देर इज अ वॉल ऑफ कन्फ्यूजन इन बिटवीन दिस टू टीम्स, DevOps ने क्या किया, इस वॉल को उन्होंने रिमूव कर दिया, राइट? अभी ये पिक्चर आप देखोगे, कंसिडर शी इज अ डेवलपर. ओके, सो उसने क्या किया, दो भी कोड लिखा. ओके, एंड शी डिलीवर्ड दिस कोड टू द ऑपरेशन टीम टू डिप्लॉय टू द प्रोडक्शन. ओके, बट वेन इट गोज टू द प्रोडक्शन द कोड ब्रोक. ओके, कोड ब्रेक हो गया, राइट? नाउ व्हाट शी इज सेइंग, लाइक इट वाज वर्किंग ऑन माय मशीन, राइट? इट इज योर प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो DevOps ने क्या किया, सो देयर वाज अ वॉल व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज अ वॉल ऑफ कंफ्यूजन. ओके, इसको ही निकाल दिया, एंड दे जस्ट मोटिवेटेड टू दिस टू एंटिटीज टू वर्क्स टुगेदर, राइट? दैट इज वॉट रिटन हियर. ओके, DevOps इज टू चेंज एंड इम्प्रूव द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन दिस टू एंटिटीज for better communication and collaboration. Okay, so this is explanation about the DevOps in very short way. Okay, so let's see, I don't want to go into the depth as a DevOps because our topic is different, but to going into the Jenkins, I would like to clear some basics. Okay, so let's see, there are six C's of the DevOps cycle. One, let's see, these are the six C's, like continuous development, continuous testing, integration, delivery, deployment, and monitoring. Let's try to understand where this come, like component comes into the phases. Okay, so for planning and coding, your continuous development will come. Okay, while building and testing, this testing will come. Integration, this deployment come into this phases, and continuous monitoring it comes under the monitoring phases. Let's try to understand which are the tools used in the DevOps cycle. Okay, I'll take it very fastly because I have to catch up the Jenkins concept also. So this is a complete infinite loop. Okay, आपने देखा होगा, बहुत सारे diagrams आपने देखे DevOps के, right? So this is complete like a infinite loop. ओके, सबसे पहला क्या होता है, हम लोगों का प्लानिंग होता है. फॉर प्लानिंग पर्पज व्हाट आर द टूल्स वी आर यूजिंग, लाइक जीरा एंड ऑल. ओके, देन कोडिंग के लिए हम लोग क्या करते हैं, जैसे इक्लिप्स में आपने कोड किया, राइट? दैट इज गोज, दैट कोड इज टू बी स्टोर्ड एट समवेयर. ओके, एट द सेंट्रल रिपोजिटरीज, SVN इज यूजिंग, गिट इज यूजिंग. ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू बिल्ड दैट कोड. ओके, फॉर द बिल्ड which tools we are using, like Maven, Ant, and Gradle. Okay, for testing these tools, there are multiple tools are available, like Selenium, your JUnit, TestNG, right? Cucumber framework is there. Now, whenever for the integration purpose, we use some kind of tools like Jenkins, Bamboo, and Hudson. Okay, we saw about the tools, CI tools. Okay, so these CI tools come into here, right? Now, once the build is completed, we have to deploy somewhere, right? So Docker will help for this, okay? And there are some tools which are used here, like Puppet, Shape, Ansible, and SolidStack. Okay, these are the which is called as a configuration management tools. Okay, अभी क्या होता है? समझ लो कि my application is on the 5 VMs. Okay, अभी 5 VMs के ऊपर है. Okay. Now suddenly what happens, Diwali ka abhi season aa gaya, okay, amazon.com abhi hamara project hai samajh lo, and suddenly Diwali ka festival aa gaya. You know what, in the festival the users ka load bahut badh jata hai. Now what they will do, they'll try to create the another instances, okay, new instances. To inhone kya kiya, 200 they decided to create a 200 more instances, okay. तो अभी क्या हुआ, जो भी सेम कॉन्फ़िगरेशन इस पांच इंस्टेंसेस के ऊपर था, सेम कॉन्फ़िगरेशन आई हैव टू इंस्टॉल इट ऑन द 200 VMs. And to install the same configuration on the 200 VMs, the manual process is very hectic. Okay, so 200 bar manually jaake install karna, it is becoming very time consuming. So to reduce this efforts, we have some tools available in the market, which is Ansible, Chef, Puppet. Okay, now after the okay deployment, there is another phase which is called as a monitor. Okay, so we have to monitor the logs for the your system. Okay, so there are multiple tools available in the market, which is Stack, Nagios, and the Splunk. Okay, so these are the very, Splunk is very good tool to monitor your, even though Nagios is also many companies are using. Okay, but my previous project we were using Splunk and the Docker, Selenium, Maven, Jira, and the Git. So Jenkins also we were using. Okay, so this is about the DevOps tools. Okay, so one of the, let's try to understand the ideal continuous delivery process. Okay, so अभी क्या हो गया, सबसे पहले developer ने code क्या किया, check in किया, and we try to get it the code into the source code management. Okay, now हम लोगों ने build किया using the Maven, and then we'll do the unit testing, and then okay, so which was missing, okay, ये missing था वहाँ पे पिछले वाले इसमें. हम लोगों ने सबसे पहले क्या किया, यूनिट टेस्टिंग किया, बट वी आल्सो डिड दी क्वालिटी चेक्स. अब ये सोनार क्या है, सोनार क्यूब इज अ स्टैटिक कोड एनालिसिस टूल. ओके, स्टैटिक कोड एनालिसिस टूल मतलब कि ये क्या करेगा, आपके सारे कोड्स को एनालिसिस करेगा ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द रूल्स. ओके, और ये डेवलपर टीम और टीम को बताएगा कि देर इज सम कोड स्मेल्स इन योर प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, कोड स्मेल मतलब इसमें कुछ बग्स है, कुछ इश्यूज है, सिक्योरिटी लूपहोल्स है, you have to fix these issues. Okay, so SonarCube, most of the companies also are using this SonarCube tool. Okay, so everything like iska bhi testing pass ho gaya, you cross the quality gates, and then we'll deploy this code to the test environment, and the test environments you do the integration testing. Okay, after integration testing, parallelly one thing which was this thing is which was missing in the previous slide, which is called as packaging and archiving. Okay, abhi company mein kya hota hai ki jaise hi code build kiya, okay, right, so we have to store this your jar file or var file. Okay, ye binaries package jo rehta hai usko kahi pe to store karna rehta hai. So in market there are couple of tools which is available, which is called as a Nexus is a tool, JFrog Artifactory. ठीक है, तो you have to store your artifact somewhere, right? Because अभी क्या हो गया, Facebook है, Facebook में क्या किया कि UPI functionality develop की and it goes into the production. और अभी क्या हो गया कि production में जाने के बाद उनको पता चला कि जैसे ये नया चेंज आया कि एग्जिस्टिंग जो फंक्शनैलिटी वो चल नहीं रही है, राइट? ऐसा होता नहीं है, बट अज्यूम फॉर द केस. ओके, तो अभी उनको क्या करना पड़ेगा, दे हैव टू रिवर्ट द कोड. ओके, दे हैव टू रिवर्ट द कोड. अभी रिवर्ट द कोड मतलब उनको वापस पुरानी आर्टिफैक्ट डिप्लॉय करनी पड़ेगी. ओके, अभी पुरानी आर्टिफैक्ट तो अपने पास है नहीं, राइट? सो इन दैट केस आवर दिस टूल इज यूजफुल, नेक्सस एंड जेफ्रॉक आर्टिफैक्टरी. ये क्या करेगा, कुछ पिछले आपकी जो भी आर्टिफैक्ट हिस्ट्री है वो सारे आर्टिफैक्ट्स आपकी स्टोर करेगा. ओके, सो इन दैट केस कभी भी कोई भी करंट इश्यू आता है करंट बिल में, करंट आर्टिफैक्ट में, सो वी कैन इजीली रिवोक द कोड और रिवर्ट टू द प्रीवियस वर्जन. ओके, प्रीवियस वर्जन ऑफ द बिल्ड. ओके, सो वी सीन सम दिस शेफ, पपेट एंड एंसिबल. ओके, ओके, सो देर आर मार्केट, इन द मार्केट देर आर to deploy into the production, like there are physical servers are there. Okay, now Amazon EC2 services are there. Okay, instances, you can create it and deploy it. Okay, Amazon Web Services there. Google Cloud is there. Okay, so you can deploy it over there also. Okay, so this is about the complete ideal process for the delivering any project. It is not like ki sare tools company use karti hai, but kuch tools use karti hai. Abhi mere project mein ye sare almost bahut sare tools use kiye hai, right? So let's see. Okay, before starting into the Jenkins, jumping into the Jenkins, till now any questions from audience? You can.
Jay here. I want to ask in short, what is artifacts exactly?
Sorry. Vijay, you are
what
not
is artifacts?
Okay, artifacts is something like when you build the code. Okay, abhi kabhi bhi koi aapka code build hota hai, right? Your code is built. Consider a Maven project is there. Okay, so in Maven there is a build folder will be created, right? In the build folder you have your jars and var, right? आपने कभी ऑब्जर्व किया होगा, राइट? नाउ दिस
यस,
व्हाट वी डू, वी जस्ट डिप्लॉय दिस जार्स एंड वार, राइट?
यस, वी कैन हियर यू.
या, ओके. सो नाउ व्हेनेवर यू, व्हाट वी कैन से, व्हेनेवर यू डू द चेंजेस इन द कोड, दिस जार्स आर ओवर रिटन. ओके, नाउ वी हैव टू स्टोर दिस प्रीवियस जार समवेयर, राइट? So that is the artifactory come into the picture. So all the previous version of your project, okay, releases, previous releases I can say, which will be stored over here.
Okay,
you got it? Yeah.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Thank you, Vijay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So let's see about the Jenkins history, like what was the history of the Jenkins. Okay, there was a developer like Kawaguchi who was the developer of Sun Microsystem, and what he was facing the issue, he was writing the code and tried to build the code and fixing the errors repeatedly. Okay, so one day this Sun Microsystem decided to create one automation server which is called as Hudson. Okay, what was the motto of this Hudson is to automate the build and test the task. Okay, so barabar code build karna and error fix karna, which was very hectic task for this developers in the Sun Microsystem. So they decided to create one project which is called as Hudson. Okay, and now all of you know that in 2010 transition happens, like Sun Microsystem taken by the Oracle, right? So jaise inka micro acquisition ho gaya, but there was a dispute in the Hudson open community. Okay, so jo ye project ke upar kaam kar rahe the, there has been a dispute in between this community. Okay, I don't want to discuss the dispute over here, but as a result in 2011 they decided we will take a vote to change the project name from Hudson to Jenkins. Okay, and the proposal was a sanction on the January 29, 2011, and the Hudson is renamed it as a Jenkins. So इन्होंने क्या किया, जो भी project था Hudson करके उसका forking करके they created a new project which is called as a Jenkins. Okay, so Jenkins you can say a replacement of the Hudson. So this was the basically the history of the Jenkins. So Jenkins, Hudson is the previous name for the Jenkins. Okay. Now let's understand what is Jenkins. Okay, so Jenkins, जैसे मैंने शुरू में भी पूछा था, I ask in the initial only कि what is Jenkins, but most of the participant has given correct answer, that is Jenkins is a CI tool, okay, continuous integration tool. But very good thing is it is a open source. Okay, one of the most popular CI tool in the market. Jenkins is a one of the most popular CI tool in the market. Over 150K installations in the worldwide. Which is the Jenkins is very user friendly, easily configurable, and installation process is very simple, which is platform independent based on Java. Okay, rich plugin ecosystem which has a very good plugins, more than 1,000 plugins which are available in the Jenkins. Okay, and you can see a very good support. Okay, for the Jenkins is available, like you can mail to the groups about the issues, or you can create a there is one dashboard, you can create a issue, like if you face any issues Likewise, we create issues in the Jira. Okay, bug jaise create karte hai in the Jira mein, waise hi they have a dashboard to create the Jenkins issues. Okay, now what happens here, the developer will commit the code to the GitHub repository. Now this Jenkins will trigger the build. Okay, and it will create the build automatically. And if the build is failed, it will notify to the developer. So this is very simple. The process is becoming very simple using the continuous integration or the Jenkins CI tool, you can say. Now, how Jenkins is useful in automation testing? Believe me, most of the testers are thinking like that Jenkins is a tool which is for the developers. Okay, but believe me, it's not like that. Most of the companies are adopting, and nowadays our testers also to be aware about the Jenkins tool, because they have to trigger the jobs and execute the test cases, or nightly build test cases they have to execute it. Okay, so what is useful for the automation tester is they can execute the functionality over the night, or they can schedule the jobs, they can execute the test cases. Then this will definitely increase. Now consider one example. If you want to execute the test case at midnight at 12 o'clock, okay. So it is not feasible to go into the office and execute the test cases at 12 o'clock, okay. So what this tester will do, it will create a job which can schedule at the midnight 12 o'clock, okay. So this will definitely save the time, because over the night the test cases will execute it and shows the result in the morning when the tester come into the office, right? So Jenkins automation display the test automation results. Okay, the Jenkins have very good feature to show the results also. Okay, so this is about the how Jenkins is useful for the automation tester. Okay, now let's see some kind of hands-on. Okay, I'll show first of all the Jenkins installation. But before the installation, is there any doubt from you guys till now? Yes, I'm going to explain what is SonarQube. Okay. Jenkins is a CI tool, continuous integration tool. I'm just answering few of the question which was there in the chat box. Okay. Any question from you guys? All are okay? Give me quick confirmation. Okay, yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, now we'll move forward, like how to install the Jenkins. Okay, okay, okay. So Jenkins installation process, what is the first step is you have to go to this website. Okay, now okay, so I'll just, you see my Chrome browser? Yes or no? I just want
yes,
to,
yes,
okay,
yes.
Yeah. I'll just write it down, download Jenkins, okay. So the very first website will come, Jenkins installation. Okay, so you can see here, you can download it from here. It will take it to here only, and there are two kinds of version. Okay, so one is called as a long-term version, and another is the weekly version. Okay, so while installing the Jenkins, you will have a couple of options, like you have to install using the Docker, you want to install on the Mac or Windows, or using the WAR file. Okay, so generally you go with the long-term support only, because this is fully tested. Okay, now where is my presentation? Yeah, okay, so I've shown you there are two approaches. Right now I have a Windows operating system. I can go ahead with the Windows one is option, and another is the using the WAR file installation. Okay, So I do have, I have installed on my machine. I do have a screenshots of all steps. Just go through the, we'll just go through the steps and I'll show you how it is. Okay. Once you download, I'll go with the first option. That is, I'll just download the file for the Windows. Okay. Now, this is the file which you get it once you download it. Okay. So this is the MSI file. And you, what you have to do, you just have to double click on that file. The one pop up will come. Okay. I'll after this session, I'll sharing these steps to all of you guys. Okay. You just install at your end. Maybe a couple of guys, you have already Jenkins install. Okay. But let's see the steps, those who are new for this session. One pop up will come. You have to just do the next and install it and just try to finish it. Okay. So this is the very generic setup. Okay. Now, once you click on the finish, one browser will open. Okay. One browser will open. In the browser, it is asking for you the administrator password. Okay. So where you get the administrator password, they have shown clearly shown here the path in C programs, Jenkins secrets and initial admin password. When you, I've shown in the picture number two, the initial admin password, if you can open it, you can see this initial password. You have to just copy it and paste it over here in the screen one. Okay. Just click on the continue. Once you continue, you will get another screen which has a two options. It will ask you to, do you want to install the plugins or you want to configure yourself as a plugin? Okay. So I've chosen the first option, like which has a very standard plugins. It will install the standard plugins automatically. Otherwise, if you want to configure yourself, you can go ahead with this second option. Okay. Now, once you install the plugin, the installation will start. It will show like this. Okay. And once the installation gets completed, you will see this screen. Okay, first screen. Okay, it will ask you to create the admin user. Okay, so I will create the username as admin, password, confirm password, and your name and the email address. Okay, so I'll click on the save and continue. Once I click on save and continue, it will show me that your Jenkins is configured for this URL and the port is 8080. Okay, so one sec, somebody is asking me one question, like how can we get Jenkins login password if we forgot? Okay, so this is what we have, initial password we have mentioned over here. Like I've put it very simple way, right? Whenever you create, consider for example, you create a email ID, right? So initially you have to mention your own password, right? So initial password is different. And creating a password for admin is different. Okay. Initial password is required to unlock the Jenkins. Okay. Now this username and password we are creating to access the Jenkins. Okay. So very first user which I have created is admin. Okay. So screen two, you can see that the configuration is completed and you can access the Jenkins through this URL. Okay. Now, once you click on save and finish, you will get this screen. Jenkins is ready to use. Start Jenkins using. Okay. So once you click on this button, you will get the next screen. Okay. So this is completely, which we call it is as a dashboard of Jenkins. You can see here my name is displayed over here, the user, there is as such, nothing is there, nothing, no jobs, no projects. It is completely very fresh. Okay. Till now, any question for the installation, because we almost done the installation. Okay. Now I will directly jump into this screen on my machine. I will share these steps to all of you guys. You can install at your end. Okay. Okay. Yeah. I hope there is no question. Okay. Let's see. Okay. So I have explained you one approach, that is using the MSI file, Windows MSI file. Okay. Now let us understand if somebody has downloaded the second option, like WAR file, somebody has downloaded, how to execute that. Okay. So when you download that WAR file, okay, so you have to open the command prompt and you have to execute this command, java-jar jenkins.war. Okay. So when you execute this command, your Jenkins will up and running. Okay, now you have to go to the browser and browse this URL. Okay, and the next steps are very clear, like unlock the users, Jenkins, installation of plugin, those are same. Okay, so this is how you can install the WAR file. But sometimes what happen, like on port 8080 already one system was configured. Okay, so by default Jenkins is configured for the port 8080, but if you want to customize this configuration, you can use this command java -jar jenkins.war and -http port. You can customize your port over here. Okay, so if I execute this command instead of this command, so my Jenkins will execute on the 9090 port. Okay, these are very simple steps. I'll share this also. Okay, now let's see how can we manage the plugins. Okay, I'll go to the my Jenkins dashboard first of all. Okay, so this is my Jenkins. Okay, I'll log out the Jenkins first. I'll just sign in. This is my admin user and the password. Okay, so like last night I have executed couple of jobs. Okay, so these are the jobs. I'll explain about these jobs later on, but there are four jobs I have already created. Okay, so this is my dashboard. Okay, now give me 1 second. Yeah, so this is my dashboard. Okay, so let's try to understand the features of the Jenkins one by one. Okay, so you see there are this is my home screen of the Jenkins. You have a new item. You can create a project or jobs over from here. The people who are connected, like you can see your users who are part of this Jenkins, then bill history, then project relationship, then check file fingerprints. Okay, very important option is that manage Jenkins. This is very important. Everything you will get it in the manage Jenkins. Now what happens, we were trying to look over here the manage plugin. Okay, so I'm into the manage plugin. How do you manage the plugin? Okay, so basically Jenkins come with some standard features. Okay, now if you want to add a few extra features into the Jenkins, you have to install the plugin. Okay, like I'll show you one example. Like if I want to use the Sonar, okay, if I want to use the Sonar, I have to install the SonarQube plugin. Okay, so you can see there are four tabs over here: updates, available, install, and advanced. Okay, so available and install, available means these are plugins available in the market. Okay, and install means I have installed this plugin on my system. So Sonar is already installed on my machine. You can see the Git. Okay, so Git related jo bhi plugins hai, that is already install on my machine. Okay, you have to install the Maven plugins. Okay, so whatever the plugins related to the Maven's already installed it. Okay, so what you have to do, by default it doesn't come with the some default plugins. Okay, like Maven you have to install it manually. Okay, so what you will do, you will just go here in the available and try to search as a Maven and try to install the Maven plugins. Okay, so this is about the manage plugin, how you can manage the plugins. Okay, so let's see. I've shown in the picture, like you have to go to the manage Jenkins, then manage plugins, then you have to go to the okay, this was the screenshot which I have taken before installing the Maven. So yeah, I have to go to the available, I have to search by Maven as a keyword, and the Maven related plugins I have selected it and clicked on the install without restart. Okay, so you can you do have another option like install and restart also. Okay, now once you install it, once you click on this button install without restart, you will see a window like this. Okay, so whatever the necessary or dependencies will be installed over here, and you will see the status on the screen also. Okay, now now let's see the global tool configuration. Okay, this is about the manage Jenkins and manage plugins. Okay, now let's try to understand the global tool configuration. What it is, you have to mention some kind of locations where some of the important things are installed. Okay, so that should be configured over here, global tool configuration, which will be used throughout your project or throughout your execution of jobs. Sorry. Now, very first configuration is about the JDK. Okay, so you have to mention where JDK is installed. Okay, so you see, I have already mentioned, like, in my local system, the JDK is installed in this path. Okay, so you have to mention the path and you have to mention the variable name. Oh, you can mention it anything. Okay, but I have just mentioned it here as a standard. Okay, Java underscore home and my JDK installed path. Okay, and you just have to apply it and save it. Okay, the very first configuration is about JDK. Now let's see the second configuration, which is Maven. Okay, now you all guys know that we also have to install the Maven on local machine also. Okay, so I have downloaded the Maven and mentioned the variable path in the system variable. Okay, so the same thing I have also mentioned it over here. What was my variable name and the Maven path? Okay, so if you see system variable, you see my Maven home, it is pointing to this path. Okay, so the same path value I have mentioned it over here also. Okay, now for Docker you have to mention it over here. I am not going with the Docker right now. Okay, about the Sonar I'll take it later, but just for now you can consider like Sonar configuration to be done over here also. Okay, now Git is fine. Okay, you don't have to mention it over here. Some people mention the Git exe file also, but that's fine. Okay, now another thing is that if somebody who don't want to specify the local path, okay, so what is another option? The Jenkins has given the another option which is called as an install automatically. When you click it this option, you will get a multiple option, like where you want to install, from where you have to install. Like I want to install it from the Oracle. Okay, so you will choose this option and which version you want to install it. You just have to select that version and click on apply, and so Jenkins will take care of this installation part. Okay, but as soon as such, this JDK is already installed on my machine, so I will not install it. I'll not select the this checkbox. Okay, so same way you can do it in Git and the Sonar Cube and the Maven also. Okay, but those things who already installed on my machine, I haven't selected the this option. Okay, this is about the global tool configuration. Let's go to the slides. Okay, so I went to the manage Jenkins, then global tool configuration, then JDK installation. Okay, so here I have shown the first approach, which is called as install automatically. Then the second approach, if already is installed. Okay. Okay, so one screen is missing, I think. Okay, so Maven. Okay, so you can install automatically Maven from the Apache. Okay. Now let's try to understand how to create and add new users. Okay. Till now everything is clear. Any question?
Hi, Nilesh. Vijay here.
Yeah, Vijay. Go ahead.
Yeah. So as you have suggested, under global tool configuration, you can get the path. Like these paths will auto populate over there, or we need to find our path location.
You have to manually write over there a path. Okay, so I already
Can you give example? Can you give example with GitHub if you have
As such, I don't.
Where is that exactly to... path you went through?
Okay, so consider I'll just delete this JDK. Okay, so when you install the Jenkins, it will come like this only. Okay, there is nothing over here in the JDK. So what I will do, I'll just click first. I'll click on the add JDK. Okay, so I will write it here. Java underscore home. Okay, and where my Java is installed on my local machine, I'll just mention this path. Okay, and I'll just apply it and save it. Okay, this is how it will be done for Maven and Sonar. I want to install automatically, so that's why I haven't done. Okay, so basically Git and Maven, these are two main configuration. Okay.
Okay.
Is it clear, Vijay?
Yes. Okay. It's clear now.
Okay. So this path I have mentioned manually, right? So the installation setup already done. So that's why the paths are showing by default only here, right? So, but by default it doesn't come with any paths. You have to enter the name and the path. Okay. Let's see. I think global configuration is okay. Global configuration is done. Now let's see how to add the user. Okay. So we do have an option over here to add the user. You can see manage users. Okay. Manage the users. अभी आप बोलोगे कि users create करना क्यों जरूरी है, right? अभी क्या है कि company में there is one project in the company, facebook.com. okay, now for this Facebook we have a 10 testers who are working parallelly. okay, now company mein ek ke credentials sabko dega to nahi chalega, right? They have to create their own users, right? They have to create the tickets accordingly, and the Jenkins administrator will create the user for them. Okay, so I'll create one sample user here, like test user. Okay, I'll mention it as a test user. Okay, I will give the password test user. Test user. Okay, whatever it is, the test@test.com. Okay, so I will now, what Jenkins administrator will do once he got the ticket, he will create the user. Okay, so once the user is created, what he will do, he will just initial password like login name and username password will provide to the those who have created the ticket. The person who has created the ticket, usko ye username and password de dega, right? Now abhi user create ho gaya, right? Let's see the slide. ओके, मैनेज यूजर्स में आए, यहाँ पे क्रिएट यूजर्स, दिस इज यूजर आई हैव क्रिएटेड एंड यू कैन सी द क्रिएट. ओके, यू कैन सी द क्रिएटेड यूजर. ओके, नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, अभी यूजर क्रिएट किया है बट इसको सब सारे चीजों का एक्सेस है. ही हैज एक्सेस ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स एज अ लाइक दोज एक्सेस फॉर द एडमिन. ऑल द एक्सेसेस आर गिवन टू दिस टेस्ट यूजर ऑल्सो. ओके, नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, एडमिन वॉन्ट टू रिस्ट्रिक्ट give some permissions to this test user. Okay, he want to restrict to do some actions done by this user. Okay, so now what he will do, he will go here, and for this you have to install one plugin which is called as a role strategy plugin. Okay, so which is already I have installed. Okay, which is I already have installed role strategy plugin. So you know how to install it, right? So you can install this role strategy plugin from this. Now admin, what he will do, he will go here, manage and assign the roles. Okay, now he will manage the roles. Okay, now how many users are there? We have a developer, tester and admin. Okay, recently created user, test user, he will add it. Okay, now once he added the user, okay, abhi isko kya kya access dena hai, overall access dena hai kya, sub Jenkins ka access dena hai kya, nahi dena hai, right? Hame usko only read ka access dena hai, right? I don't want to modify any modification done by this user. Okay, to mai kya karunga, jahan jahan pe mujhe read dikh raha hai, right? Okay, so read. Okay, I can read the jobs. Okay, where is the read? Okay, read the jobs. I can run ka option nahi dena hai mujhe, aur view ka dena hai, right? So I can view the jobs. Now I think that's fine. Okay, so I will click it, apply, save. Okay, now what I will do, I will go to my another browser. here localhost 8080. Okay, now I'll log in by test user. Okay, test user sign in. Okay, अभी ये क्या बोल रहा है, टेस्ट यूजर इज मिसिंग द ओवरऑल रीड राइट परमिशन. ओके, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वाज द इशू. ओके, वन ऑफ द परमिशन. ओके, ये रिप्ले नहीं. ओके, that's fine. Like something happened, give me 1 second. Okay, I'll just explain you one login by the user. I already have created a tester user. Okay, so I'll just do the login by the tester. Password. Okay, so
maybe same port se hoga, so that's why it's on access same port.
Kya kya? Okay, that's fine. Like this is not a big but you can configure the user from this window, right? So I've done this thing last night only, but okay, so admin do this thing, like कौन से स्क्रीन का आपको एक्सेस देना है. यू हैव टू क्रिएट द जॉब. कॉन्फिगर कर सकते हैं कि नहीं कर सकते. बिल्ड परमिशंस. यू कैन रन द जॉब्स और नॉट. दैट एवरीथिंग इज टू बी. लेट मी क्यू. लेट मी वन मोर सेकंड क्विकली. आई गो टू द मैनेज Jenkins एंड ट्राई टू सी द यूजर्स. Okay, so user ID is test user. Okay, so okay, the user ID is user 2. Okay. Okay, so user 2 is login. Okay, I have deleted that user. Okay, so because of that it is not able to log in. Okay, now what I will do, I'll just go to my manage Jenkins and the assigned roles, manage role. You see my user 2 is not added, right? User 2. The same you have to add it here. Okay. Overall read. Save it, apply it. Okay. Now. Okay. Jobs. Okay. Let's try to save this, and I'll not spend too much of time on this because this is not a big you can do at your end also. Okay. So consider this. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so you see, this is my admin user. Okay, and how many options are there? You can delete the project, configure, and all, right? But for this user, user two, how many options you can see? He cannot delete the project, right? So that should be managed by the roles. Okay, so just want to show that only. Okay, so it's working now, right? So company mein aise hota hai ki users ko configure karke एक्सेसेस दिए जाते हैं. अब अभी क्या होता है कि कभी कभी क्या होगा, यूजर क्रिएट हो गया बट ही डोंट हैव परमिशन टू क्रिएट द जॉब. सो वो लोग क्या बोलेंगे, एडमिन क्या बोलेगा, प्लीज क्रिएट द टिकट फॉर दिस एंड गेट इट अप्रूव्ड फ्रॉम योर मैनेजर. ओके, देन ही विल क्रिएट द टिकट एंड दिस टिकट इज असाइन टू दिस जेनकिंस एडमिन एंड ही विल असाइन द परमिशन टू यू एंड देन यू विल एबल टू सी द क्रिएट जॉब फंक्शनैलिटी ओवर हियर. ओके ओके, नाउ विल गो बैक टू द पीपीटी. ओके, यू सी. Okay, so this is the plugin which I have to install it. Role-based authorization strategy. Once I install it, you have to do one more setting in the configure global security. That is, authorization is to be done by role-based strategy. Okay, so once you save it, go to the manage and assign roles, manage roles. You have to click the roles. क्या क्या रोल्स देने हैं, जॉब बिल्ड कर सकता है, कैंसिल कर सकता है, कॉन्फिगर कर सकता है, क्रिएट कर सकता है, डिलीट कर सकता है. सो सच काइंड ऑफ रोल्स यू कैन प्रोवाइड टू दिस यूजर्स. यू जस्ट सेव इट एंड यू कैन सी दी ये दी रोल्स असाइन टू दी यूजर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स ट्राई टू वेरी कोर पार्ट ऑफ द जेनकिंस. विल कम टू द कोर पार्ट ऑफ द जेनकिंस, दैट इज हाउ टू क्रिएट द जॉब और द project. Okay, I will just delete this. Close tab. Okay, yeah. Okay, so what I will do, I will create one sample project in my Eclipse. Okay, you all see my screen? Eclipse.
Yes.
Okay. So what I will do, I will just create one Java project, simple Java project. Okay. So this is my Jenkins test one project. Okay. So this is my Jenkins test one simple Java project. ऐसे assume करो कि company के पास एक project आया है Jenkins test one नाम का, right? So what I will do, I'll just create one class file over here. Okay, so which is called hello one. I'll create. Okay, now I just simply write it over here, one thing, that is hello Jenkins. Okay, and I have saved this project. Nothing hard and fast, very simple. I have created one Java project and one line only I have added, that is hello Jenkins. Okay, abhi ye maine jo project kiya hai, that project is on my local machine. Okay, I have to push this code somewhere on the remote side, right? Okay, so what I will do, I will create one repository for this. I will create one repository for this. This is my GitHub account. Okay, I will create one repository which is called as a Jenkins test one. Okay, I will create. I think you all are familiar with the Git and GitHub. मैंने आई थिंक इसके पहले भी सेशन लिया है Git and GitHub. Okay, so I think if you are not aware about the process and all, we'll have a session on this Git and GitHub later on. Okay, but main bhi thoda sa fast karunga because we are running with the very short of time. So let's see, this is my project on my GitHub. I've created a remote repository which is called a Jenkins test one. Okay, so this is my URL for this repository. Okay, what I will do, मेरे अभी लोकल पे जो कोड है, राइट, आई हैव टू पुश दिस कोड समवेयर ऑन द रिमोट साइड. ओके, सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल जस्ट क्रिएट, आई विल जस्ट गो टू द टीम्स एंड शेयर द प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, सो आई विल डू इट वेरी क्विकली. आई विल क्रिएट माय लोकल रिपोजिटरी. वंस द लोकल रिपोजिटरी इज क्रिएटेड, आई विल जस्ट ट्राई टू कमिट माय कोड टू द रिमोट साइड. ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट कमिट इट एंड फर्स्ट कमिट. ओके, ओके, so I'll just, this is my repository, my master. Yeah, fine, that is okay. Okay, as such, this is related, the session is more focused on the Jenkins, that's why I'm not discussing more commands on the of the Jenkins. Okay, so we'll discuss it later. Okay, how it happens and all. Okay, so I'll just refresh it. You see my Jenkins project, local Jenkins project came on the remote side, right? Is it clear? Give me just quick confirmation, like, is it all are okay? Yeah, we will have a Git session later on. Okay, where I can explain all the processes, ye kaise kiya maine, ye sab kuch main aapko explain karunga. No worries. Okay, अभी के लिए फिर सिर्फ इतना ध्यान में रखो कि मैंने लोकल पे प्रोजेक्ट किया वो मैंने रिमोट पे पुश कर दिया. That's it. Okay. Yeah, good. Okay, चलो अभी मैंने रिमोट में ये कोड पुश कर दिया, बट आई हैव टू क्रिएट अ जॉब फॉर दिस प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, तो अभी मुझे कहाँ जाना पड़ेगा, मेरे जेनकिंस में, राइट? सो आई हैव हियर अ ऑप्शन एज अ न्यू आइटम. ओके, सो मैं यहाँ पे जाऊँगा, यहाँ पे लिखूंगा जेनकिंस टेस्ट वन. ओके, ये मेरा प्रोजेक्ट है. प्रोजेक्ट, let's consider a freestyle project for now. Okay, let's consider a freestyle project for now. Okay, now I will click OK. पहले मैं freestyle project करके दिखाऊंगा, then we will see the Maven project. Okay, पहले freestyle project देखते हैं, right? Once I click on OK, I have to configure few things. Okay, ये मेरे project का configuration पहले मुझे setup करना पड़ेगा. Okay, so project का description क्या है, this is my Jenkins test one project. Okay, I'll write the description. Okay, now where you want to get this code, I would like to get this code from the my repository. Okay, so where is my repository? This is my repository URL. Okay, I will mention it here. Okay, now to access this repository, you have to mention the credentials, like your GitHub credentials, username and password. Okay, so I already have saved this credential. Okay, agar aapne save nahi kiya, if you haven't saved this credential, you can add it from here. Okay, once you add it from here, it will be populated in the drop down. Okay, so I'll show you quickly how to do it. Okay, see here. Okay, I'll add it here, my username, my password and description, my GitHub account, like this, and I will add it. Okay, so once you add it will be populated over here. Okay, so from the build is to be taken from which branch, I would like to take it from my master. Okay, so this is about the source code management. Now let's see the build trigger. Okay, so when it okay, so we do have couple of option over here. Okay, so build triggers, what is triggers? It means like when this build is to be triggered. Okay, so I'll explain couple of option, like build periodically, this is mostly used, and polysium and GitHub trigger. Okay, so I'll explain this, or this is also used, like build after other projects are built. Okay, let's explain this build periodically first of all. Okay, so what it says that it is using the cron pattern. Okay, cron pattern, if you go here and click on the question mark, it will show you the hint. Okay, how the cron pattern to be created. Okay, for now I'll create one sample cron pattern. Okay, so if I give it stars star. If I give it 5 times star, what it means here? It will show you. Do you mean every minute when this means that every minute your project will be built? Okay, so what it is saying that the previous build was at this time and the next build it will be okay. So you can see here. Okay, the next build will be at this time only. Okay, now this is not the recommended practice, like use it this. Okay, if I want to execute this build after every 12 hours, okay, so you have to mention the accordingly, like first hour is mentioned for the hours, minutes, seconds and all, okay, days. Okay, you can go this hint, okay, minute, hour, date of the month and date of week. Okay, so this is how it accordingly configured. Okay, so for now I'm not using the build periodically. Let's see build after other projects. Okay, my project is this Jenkins test one. Okay, but to build this project I want to build something else. Okay, there are some dependency on the previous projects also. Okay, so if I want to build the this test one project before new UI project. Okay, so you have to mention it here, like once this new UI project will build and then this project will be triggered. So this is before a build after the this specified project will be built. Okay, now let's see the Git webhook option. I'll explain the PoleSCM. Okay, PoleSCM, the similar way you have to mention the cron pattern. Okay, and accordingly it will pull the code from your source code management system. Okay, so what's basically difference between build periodically and PoleSCM? Okay, if I mention it here, what it means, every 1 minute it will build my job. Okay, build my project. But PoleSCM, it means that whenever there is a change in my project, that means whenever you commit a new thing into the project, that time only this project will be built or this job will be built. So this is the main difference between this build periodically and the PoleSCM. Let's try to understand. There are some good practices using the industries, which is a GitHub webhook trigger. What it means, like if you go here, this is my remote repository. If you go to the setting, okay, if you go to the setting, you will have the webhook as an option. Okay, so where you have to mention the Jenkins URL, you have to add the Jenkins URL here. Okay, and just add the webhook. Okay, I'm not adding the webhook right now because my Jenkins is deployed on my local machine. Okay, so local webhook, you cannot configure the local URL as a webhook. Okay, so for this, NGRX is a tool which is to be used to make it this local IP to the public IP. Okay, so what is webhook is, consider a scenario. I'm working on this project and I did some changes over here. Okay, and my second commit came here. Okay, as soon as my GitHub feels that there is a change in the code, it will trigger that Jenkins endpoint. Okay, if you select this option, this Git will trigger the webhook for the Jenkins, and now Jenkins will build the job automatically. Okay, so this is what the GitHub webhook trigger option. Okay, for now I'm not doing anything. I just want to do it manually. Okay, now what I will do, I'll just how I want to build the project. I'll just use this shell script. Okay, so what was my is hello 1.java. okay, what I will do, I'll just java c hello 1.java and java hello 1. Okay, this is something which I have written very simple way. Just save it and apply it and save it. This is how my simple freestyle project is.
Guys, you're also
Yeah.
facing the same issue.
Okay, give me 1 minute. Okay, so you see my screen? Hello?
Yes, we can see your screen.
Okay.
Yeah, you can see your screen.
Okay, so no problem. Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, so we created a project as a Jenkins test one. We configured it and now it's time to build the project. Okay, so there is an option over here, right? So build now. Okay, so what it will do right now, we just created the project in the Jenkins. It doesn't have anything in the workspace. You see, nothing is there, right? Okay, so I have to pull the code from the GitHub and execute that build. Okay, so I'll click on the build now. As soon as you click on the build now, you will see here a build is triggered. Okay, now it is trying to build the project. Okay, you see console output. Now this blue symbol says that the build is successful. Okay, you see what it is doing. It is cloned my repository to the local Jenkins server and it is executed this script. And what was my printf statement in the written in the code? Hello Jenkins. Okay, so it is printed successfully over here. Okay, so my job is successful. You see, this is my build version 1. Okay, so this is a very simple project. Okay, simple freestyle project I have created and shown you. Okay, now let's try to see how we can create the Maven project and build it through the Jenkins. Okay, so I do have created one Maven project which is called as a UI testing. Okay, so inside that nothing is there. Like I just have written one small class which is just invoking my Chrome browser and just I've written a 3 test. One test case is like navigate to the google.com and get the title, just printing the title. Okay, second test is very the same way. Okay, test 1, test 2 and test 3 by intentionally I have filled it. Okay, because I am just getting the title and just assert the title. Okay, so yeah,
Vijay here.
Yeah, Vijay, go ahead.
Actually your voice is not synchronizing with your no screen sharing.
Okay, the screen is slow, you are saying. Okay,
point,
right now what you are saying?
I think right now I can see a testng.java that under that class we have some testng format test cases we wrote.
Okay, yeah, okay, so that is what I'm explaining. Please bear with me because I think I have connected through my mobile phones and might be a network issue for a few time because Wi-Fi is disconnected because of power failure. So let's see, like if you feel that it is a more lag in the my shared screen and the voice, then might be we can schedule a next session. Okay, so instead of moving forward. Okay, but let's see like how it is. Okay, shall I continue?
Is not sorry to interrupt. Screen is not visible. Yes, sir.
I have.
It's visible.
Hello.
Yeah, it's visible. I have shared the screen.
Yes, it's visible. We can see
this. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Some
yeah. Okay, so these are my three test cases I have written. Okay, now what I will do, I'll just create another repository. Okay. All of you see my GitHub screen?
Visible.
Okay, so what I have done, I have created one Maven project in my Eclipse. Okay, I have written three sample test cases. Okay, but it is on my local machine, right? I have to push this code somewhere on a remote side. But pushing this code to the remote side, I have to create the remote repository first of all. So what I'm doing, I'm just creating first of all a remote repository. Okay, so UI testing is my remote repository. Now I will push my local code to the remote repository, the same thing which we did it for the freestyle project, the same way I'm doing. Okay. Okay, so my local repository is created. Now I will just try to push this my changes to my remote server. Yes, okay, so everything is correct. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, my first commit is pushed. Okay, to the remote. Yeah, push confirmation, we got it. Now let's try to refresh the page and see the changes are reflected on a remote side or not. Oh. UI testing. Yeah, pushing right now it is pushing happening, right? You see 41%. It will take some time. It depends on your internet connection. I don't know why it is taking.
So, Nilesh, will that, can I ask you one question?
Yeah, yeah, sure. Meanwhile, you can ask. Yeah.
Yeah, you know. Yeah. So, you take the, you know, check-in process or something like committing the process from your local machine to a central repository.
Right.
So, whatever I have learned from the last session, you can do it in by doing Git bash.
Right.
Git is bash. It same something like you
same,
do it
same.
Here and what you. And what we do in a Git bash?
Yeah, the same way, right? What I did, I have just in industry, like people are using the Git bash also, right? But the people, to make the process very faster, we enable this feature in the in the Eclipse using the Git plugin, right? So you have to go to the marketplace and install the Git plugin. Okay, so when you install the plugin in the Eclipse, the same options are available in the Eclipse also. Okay, you don't have to remember the commands and all. Okay, everything is faster, and I think you have seen, right? Within a 15 seconds I did commit and push, right? So I think
it took for me nearly 5 minutes because I'm a beginner. I'm beginner in the Git bash. So
yes, I agree with you.
When I have went for that, it took about 5 minutes.
Yes, I agree with you, but it will take some time to familiar with the processes. Okay, I don't know why it is. Updates are available. Click to review and install. Let's try to refresh this. Is it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, nothing pushed. Maybe a network error. Okay, so let's try to do it again. What I will do, I will just insert a semicolon. I'll try to save it and try to push it my second commit. And commit and push. Let's see. You see, push to UI testing, origin 51%. This needs to be complete, right? Okay, so meanwhile, I can go ahead with the slides. Okay, so I'll explain you one more thing, that is master slave configuration. Let's see what is master slave configuration. Okay, so what is general practice in the industry, right? You are in the industry, there is not a single Jenkins server. Okay, so there might be chances that the single Jenkins server cannot handle your load, right? So in that case, you have to create the nodes for this Jenkins, right? So how this is what the architecture of the Jenkins is. Master slave configuration I have shown here. So this is my master Jenkins node, which is okay. Yeah.
Not able to see.
Yeah. Okay. We create a build.
Yes. Now it's we can see.
Okay. Yeah. So you see, this is my master node. And these are my slaves. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so the TCP connection is used to do the communication in between these two entities. Okay, so what is, I'll tell you why we need a slaves. Okay, consider a scenario that there are a couple of the things which has to be executed on your Linux server, right? So what I will do, I'll just try to create one Linux slave, okay, Linux node, and I'll try to connect this node with the Jenkins master. Okay, I'll show you on the next slide like how I created the nodes in the Jenkins. Okay, you see, what you have to do, you have to go to the Jenkins, and there is one option like manage nodes and create the nodes. Okay, so when you okay, you see my this screen, whereas I have highlighted new node.
Not yet.
Okay, screen is freezing.
No, actually,
yeah,
screen is got freezed.
Okay, let's try to refresh the chain.
Processing with the agent.
Okay, now my Git is having the changes. Okay, but it is okay. I think if the screen is this slow, maybe I cannot explain you properly. Might be I'll talk with Avinash, like we can have a quick session, because only a 15 minutes or 20 minutes session.
Yeah, Nilesh. We can do one thing, like, you know, if we have a lot of bunch of thing if you have to explain, then we can arrange it after you get the power, you know, if you get the power, we can do something like that, because it's your voice and your screen sharing is not synchronizing.
Yeah. Yes, I can understand.
It's,
yeah,
it is creating confusion for us.
Yeah, I can understand. Yes, because I have connected through my mobile phone, and might be WebEx is taking so much of load. I think I have used the GoToMeeting and other stuff, but they are a bit lightweight. I'm not sure about the WebEx because I'm using first time. So prettier times like Zoom and the GoToMeetings works on my mobile internet. But let's see, like, okay, so what we'll do, we'll just have, we'll plan a next session for the remaining stuff. Okay, but I think we can discuss the question answers for now, because what is remaining is I'll try to show you how to create the master slave configuration and how to create the Maven project and try to push it to the source code management, and where I can trigger the Jenkins job. Okay, that is remaining. I'll show that. And another thing I want to show you, that is when my job is failed or something is failed, how that is to be notified to the developer. Okay, so we have to do the SMTP configuration in the Jenkins. So that I will show you. Okay, so these three things is remaining. And another thing is remaining, that is a pipeline. Okay, so Jenkins pipeline, something which is I have pipe schedule in the or plan in the next session, but I will explain it in the next session only. Okay, the one thing is remaining, that is SonarQube configuration in the Jenkins. Okay, or what is SonarQube? Okay, so that I will tell you. Okay, and how in industry, like, code is static code analysis is done in the industry, that I will tell you. Okay, so this is something which is pending from my end. I'll explain it in the next session, but for now, from my side, it is done. We can have a quick round of question answer session. Okay. Yeah, you can unmute yourself and ask if you want.
May I proceed, Nilesh?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I have a question, like, you know, while I was working, while I'm working in my organization,
yeah,
my team members and automation testers used to ask me that run this build and try to execute and see what is the result. I used to get the result, but I'm not able to identify how many test cases that job actually ran, because I haven't seen how many test cases, because they have build, they have created the build and they have executed, but I'm not able to clarify that how many test cases are included in that build. How can we verify those things in Jenkins, or we have different way for that?
Right. Yeah. Good question. Okay, so I'll tell you, like, now as per my understanding, currently they are giving you the build manually, right? How they give you the build?
Yeah, they used to give on Excel sheet, they used to provide for these testers, these are the build names,
right? Yeah,
so we used to get this build and we used to search it in the Jenkins search box.
Okay, and how do you, where these builds are deployed? On your local machine or somewhere on the server?
I think on the server. It's okay. Not a local machine.
Okay. Server. Okay. So there is some on the remote server, it is to be deployed. Okay. I think it is also to be done manually, or you are doing the deployment part, or the developers already deployed on the server?
No. For us, it's just we need to go on that specific job name, and we just need to click on the build now, and we just need to run the build, and we just need to check what are the results, what are the test cases that got failed.
Okay,
but I'm not able to identify how many test cases they have created for that job.
Right, so I'll explain you, like, how they link it. Okay, so okay, I'll explain you how they do it. Okay, first of all, consider X project. Okay, Facebook project, they are working on it, and they created a build for this. Okay, but to create a build, they have to create a job on a Jenkins side. Okay, so first job I will create, Facebook build job. Okay, this is my first job. Okay, now what they will give you, the name of the this build job. Okay, so just build it. Okay, I have shown you like how we can build the job manually. Okay, at the left side we have a couple of options like to build the jobs. Okay, now once the build has been done, okay, what next to be done? Okay, so they will create another job. Okay, they will create the another job that is called as a something we can say a code analysis. Okay, or to before the building we should do the code analysis part. Okay, like how is the coding standards are followed or not. Okay, so that is in my industry the first job is the code analysis. The code analysis first of all do, if it passes then only we do the builds. Or sometimes it happens code analysis, whatever the result of the code analysis, we do the build and we share the result to the team, like build is successful but code analysis is failed. Okay, you have to fix this code analysis. Okay, now consider code analysis done, build is done. Okay, now we have to execute this couple of test cases. Now how this to be in, linked? Okay, now consider we have another project as a Facebook test. Okay, so core project is Facebook, which is linked to my Facebook build job. Okay, now we have another project as a Facebook test where all the test cases, automation test cases, your regression test cases are written into the that project Facebook test. What I will do, I'll create a testing job for this. Okay, and now what I will do, I'll just configure this job in the manner like when build is successful, my build is job successful, my test cases to be test case job to be triggered. Okay, now this test cases are linked to my GitHub repository. Okay, so in my company we were not using the GitHub, we were using Bitbucket. Okay, so we try to okay, so the configuration part is not done by the our team members. Okay, it is completely done by the DevOps team. Okay, but what, why I'm telling you just for your knowledge purpose, like how they do the configuration and all. Okay, once this testing job is executed, my test cases pass, we do have another job which is called as a deploy. Okay, now or we do have another thing which is called as artifactory. Okay, where do we push this artifactory? Nowadays Amazon S3 is also there. Okay, so where you can push your artifactory is there. Nexus is there. Okay, so JFrog artifactory is there, where you push your artifactories. Okay, before goes into the production. Okay, now after that I have to deploy this my jar or var file to somewhere. Okay, so you have a different kinds of environments, right? First of all, test environment, some people are doing manual testing. Okay, but to do the manual testing on the environment, it should be deployed, right? The code should be deployed first. Okay, right, so my deploy job will do that thing. Okay, so if you combine everything, this becomes my pipeline. Okay, where it comes the pipeline in the picture. Okay, is it clear? Anybody has any question? Hello? Am I audible?
Nilesh, can I ask you one more question?
Yeah, sure.
Awesome. So for, you know, for installing, you said we have var that strategy. From that strategy also we can install the Jenkins.
Yes.
And from Windows also we can install, right?
Yes.
And for var we can, for var files we can go through, like we can change the port number by using some command lines,
right?
How can we do the same thing through Windows? Let's suppose we have another system which is ported with 8080.
All right.
And then at that time, if we have installed it from Windows, then how we can change the port that time?
Okay, good question. So your MSI, okay, I have to look into it, like how you can change the port for the Windows installation. I'll get back to you on this. Okay. Yeah, thanks for the question.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah, okay, but believe me, I have installed the Windows on my machine, but I was facing one error in the email configuration. Okay, so what I did, I just downloaded my the var file and executed that command only, and now it is working absolutely fine. So so I'm using the var version right now. Any question? I think CI, I have explained you the CI, CI processes, CI tools, then continuous delivery, continuous deployment. We see some basics of the DevOps. Then we see how to add the users, then manage the plugins, and how to create the job. Freestyle job I have shown you. Okay. Okay, I think most of the questions are clear. So thank you so much, guys, and we'll see like how we can plan the further session. Please be connected with the Avina. She will inform you like about the next session, and let us know the feedback for this session, like you like it or not, and what kind of improvements you needed. Some things are a bit faster, but yeah, you can reach out to me if it is not, anything is not clear. Yeah, thank you so much, guys, and see you later. Yeah.